We're learning to live with it. We have no choice. We can't lock ourselves up in a basement like Joe does. He has the ability to lock himself up.
He says that we're learning to live with it. People are learning to die with it. You folks home will have an empty chair at the kitchen table this morning. That man or wife going to bed tonight and reaching over to try to touch their out of habit where their wife or husband was is gone. Learning to live with it. Come on. And by the way, all you teachers out there, not that many of you are going to die, so don't worry about it. So don't worry about it. Come on. He doesn't want to talk about the substantive issues. It's not about his family and my family. It's about your family. And your family's hurting badly. The idea that the stock market is booming is his only measure of what's happening. Where I come from in Scranton and Claymont, the people don't live off of the stock market.
And he doesn't come from Scranton. That's like one of the, he lived there for a short period of time before he even knew
it. We're going to move on
to
the
next. And he left.
The idea that the fact that there's a public option that people can choose, that makes it a socialist plan. Look, the difference between the president, I think health care is not a privilege, it's a right. Everyone should have the right to have affordable health care. And I am very proud of my plan. It's gotten endorsed by all the major labor unions, as well as a whole range of other people who, in fact, are concerned in the medical field.
It was really a big bailout for badly run Democrat cities and states.
All right,
if I get elected, I'm running as a proud Democrat, but I'm going to be an American president. I don't see red states and blue states. What I see is American, United States.
So 51 million Americans have already voted. I don't know how much of a difference this is going to make, but Biden clearly won the debate. There was maybe one moment where Trump was able to corner him, and it was on the crime bill. But other than that, Biden just crushed it on the relevant topics that Americans are experiencing right now. So the red states, blue states line there, I'll admit it, that's that kind of old statesmanly centrism, but really a more stable politician talk that I think people are yearning for because of this Trump fatigue. And it's true. And it was very effective there. So Biden distinguished himself as better than Trump in pretty much every way in this debate. So one, on COVID, when he said, we're learning to die with it, after Trump said, we're learning to live with it. That was a great line. That was a great line. He came across as very passionate on the topic. He cared about the loss of life, and Trump continued to downplay it. And it just isn't effective when everyone is experiencing the horrors of COVID-19 and the fallout from it to just try to do a PR spin on it. It's when people are facing the tangible consequences of crises, you can't just do your Trump Incorporated media spin on it. It's just not going to work. And Trump keeps trying to go after the swine flu, the Obama administration's handling of the swine flu. This is the worst line of attack I have ever seen, potentially. No one remembers the swine flu, really. No one cares about it. It didn't cause an economic depression. It didn't kill over 220,000 Americans. Bro, who is advising you to keep talking about the swine flu? Ridiculous. Healthcare. Biden was way better on Trump than Trump on that. He explained the concept of a public option, which is part of his policy. And obviously, I believe in single-payer healthcare, but Biden talking about the public option was very good. I'm not expecting Biden to come out in favor of single-payer healthcare. He disparages Medicare for All and did that thing again last night where he gratuitously went after, I beat Bernie, I beat all those people in the primary. Okay, Joe, you don't need to alienate, we're all voting for you anyway because Trump's so terrible, you don't need to alienate Bernie voters. But I digress, it's a very minor point. The economy, that stock market line, whoo, whoo, I mean, it's true. Regular Americans are in deep crisis right now. When Trump's talking about the stock market, and talking about practice, talking about swine flu, talking about the stock market, like, that's very effective because over half of Americans don't have any investment in the stock market. And they are facing extreme economic harm. Again, 26 plus million Americans on unemployment insurance, over 30 million Americans, well over, we don't know the full numbers, don't have health insurance. Over 60% of Americans will have zero savings or emergency funds by the end of the year. So those are more pertinent than your rich buddy's stock portfolio. It made Trump look really out of touch and like a terrible leader there. And then he tries to turn around and say, well, Biden's not really from Scranton. Bro, I never say bro more than when I'm talking about Trump. I don't know why. But like, you look so petty. Trump looked so petty throughout this debate where Biden was talking about issues and Trump couldn't be a bully because that clearly polled so poorly the first time around. So he was still petty, but without the bravado. And it just, it made him look weak and it made Biden look like he was caring about the issues. And as another point to that, Trump did this very grandiose delivery where he says, "I was put through a phony witch hunt." And Biden just rolls his eyes. No one cares about your witch hunt as people are in serious pain. This stuff doesn't play. This is a time of crisis. And Biden looked passionate, empathetic. He was sharp for him. And the facts were on his side. And that's really the overall theme of this. Trump looked petty. Biden looked like he was talking about the issues that people are dealing with right now. Joe Biden did a better job in the final debate on Thursday, according to a CNN instant poll of debate watchers. Overall, 53% of voters who watched the debate said that Biden won the matchup, while 39% said that President Donald Trump did. Viewers once again said that Biden's criticisms of Trump were largely fair. 73% said they were fair, 26% unfair. And they split over whether Trump's attacks on Biden were fair. 50% said yes, 49% said no. I mean, Trump was going after Biden's sons again, albeit not in the cruelest way possible like he did the first time around, but there were many of them that were unfair and below the belt. That's a more positive outcome for Trump. In a CNN instant poll after the first presidential debate, just 28% said they thought the president had won the debate and 67% called his criticism of Biden unfair. More debate watchers said Trump's performance raised concerns about how he would handle the presidency, 55%, than did Biden's, 41%. Yeah, so I actually do think Trump did a little bit better this time around. It was hard to do worse than the first debate, but Biden also didn't do that well in the first debate. Trump was just so outrageous and below the belt that he lost by default. It was like no one was trying to win that game, kind of like the Eagles-Giants game last night. Broke my heart. It broke my heart. By the way, Daniel Jones, he fell, but they scored a touchdown on that drive, guys. So let's get off his butt. He ripped off an 80-yard run. He actually played kind of well. It was the rest of the team. I digress. I'm still hurting from that loss. Anyway, Biden, though, definitively won this one. Again, I don't know how many minds it's going to change, but it's got to make people who are a little bit on the fence feel somewhat better about Biden, because it seemed like he had a vision where Trump was just talking about himself. I, the whole night. That's not going to play to apolitical suburban voters, specifically women, who Trump is losing badly to Biden on, in some polls, 2-1. Those are the people that Trump needs to win over, and he did not do that in comparison to Biden last night.